Cambridge IGCSE Chemistry May, June 2020, Paper 4. Question 1. This question is about elements X, Y, and Z. Part A. An atom of element X is represented as X3416. Name the different types of particles found in the nucleus of this atom of X. They are protons and neutrons. What is the term for the total number of particles in the nucleus of an atom? It's nuclear number, and it stands for the number of protons plus neutrons. What is the total number of particles in the nucleus of an atom of X3416? The upper number stands for the nuclear number, so it's 34. What is the electronic structure of the ion X2-? Well, the element X had 16 protons, so it would have had 16 electrons, but since it's an ion now, with a charge of negative 2 in total, it will have 18 electrons. The structure would be 2, 8, and 8. Suggest the formula of the compound formed between aluminum and X. The element X has 6 outer electrons and aluminum is in group 3, so it has 3 outer electrons. As a result, Al2X3 would be formed. Part B. What term is used to describe atoms of the same element with different number of particles in the nucleus? Different number of particles in the nucleus, specifically the number of neutrons, can be found in isotopes. Identify the atom against which the relative masses of all other atoms are compared. What do you use to compare the relative mass? It's carbon-12. What is the name of the amount of any substance that contains 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 particles? They are called a mole. The constant 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 has a name. What is the name of this constant? It's the Avogadro constant. Part C. Part of the definition of relative atomic mass is the average mass of naturally occurring atoms of an element. Some relative atomic masses are not whole numbers. Element Y has only two different types of atom, Y69 and Y71. The ratio of atoms present in element Y is shown. It's 3:2. Calculate the relative atomic mass of element Y to one decimal place. In this case, you will have to multiply each number from the ratio with the mass of each different types of atom. So 3 times 69 and 2 times 71. Now add them together and divide them with the total sum of these two ratios, which is 5. The answer is 69.8. Identify element Y. Look at the periodic table and we can see that gallium has an atomic mass of 70, very close to 69.8. So the answer is gallium. Part D. Element Z is in period 3 and group 5. Identify element Z. Back to the periodic table. This is period 3 and group 5 is here, and the overlapping element is phosphorus. Explain in terms of electron transfer why Z behaves chemically as a nonmetal. Z, phosphorus, is in group 5, meaning it has 3 outer electrons. So to be stable, it will gain 3 electrons when forming ions. Gaining electrons is the characteristic of a nonmetal, and that answers the question. Question 2. Magnesium is a metal. Part A. Name and describe the bonding in magnesium. It's a metal, so it's metallic bonding. For the description of bonding, in metallic bond, there are a sea of electrons floating around the positive ions. Also, there is a strong attraction between the electrons and the positive ions. Part B. Magnesium oxide, MgO, is formed when magnesium burns in oxygen. Complete the dot and cross diagram to show the electron arrangement of the ions in magnesium oxide. The inner shells have been drawn. Give the charges on the ions. This diagram represents ionic bonding. Look at the periodic table and find which groups magnesium and oxygen belong to. Magnesium is in group 2 and oxygen is in group 6. So in this bonding, magnesium should give 2 electrons to oxygen in order to form a complete outer shell. In this case, we need to draw 6 more dots here to show that it became a full octet. There should be 6 crosses in this oxygen ion since oxygen carries 6 electrons in general and 2 more dots added which have been donated by magnesium. The charges are plus 2 and minus 2 according to the number of electrons they lost and gained. Write the chemical equation for the reaction that occurs when magnesium burns in oxygen. Mg plus O2 should equal to MgO. The question mentioned this, and if you balance it, it's like this. Part C. Magnesium oxide also forms when magnesium nitrate, MgNO32, is heated strongly. This is an endothermic reaction. Write the chemical equation for this reaction. Endothermic reaction of a nitrate compound produces an oxide, NO2, and oxygen. You need to remember this point. Then, balance it, of course. What type of reaction is this? It's heated to break down, so it's a thermal decomposition. Name 2 other compounds of magnesium that form magnesium oxide when heated. They are carbonate and hydroxide compounds, so magnesium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide. Question 3. Sulfur dioxide SO2 is used in the manufacture of sulfuric acid. Part A. In the first stage of the process, sulfur dioxide is obtained from sulfur-containing ores. Name one of these ores. The ore for sulfur is zinc blend. Part B. The next step of the process is a reaction which can reach equilibrium. The equation for this stage is shown. 2SO2 plus O2 gives 2SO3. Describe 2 features of an equilibrium. This is basically like the definition of an equilibrium. The reaction is reversible, the sign stands for that, and the rate of forward reaction equals to the rate of reverse reaction. Name the catalyst used in this stage. For this, it's vanadium 5 oxide. Why is a catalyst used? Catalyst increases the rate of reaction, so it takes less time. Explain in terms of particles why a high temperature increases the rate of this reaction. Okay, this is a general question on the relationship between temperature and the rate of reaction. When temperature increases, particles have more energy, and this increases the rate of collisions between them. Also, there will be a higher proportion of particles that have energy greater than the activation energy, allowing the reaction to occur. In this stage, only a moderate temperature of 450 degrees Celsius is used. What does this suggest about the forward reaction? 450 degrees Celsius is still a high temperature, and this is because, as I mentioned in the previous question, you need high temperature for higher rate of reaction. But the question said it's moderate, meaning it's been controlled to be lower. This suggests that the temperature shouldn't be so high, so forward reaction should be exothermic, which works best at lower temperatures. Or you can just memorize that the forward reaction of this equilibrium is an exothermic reaction, since it's a common question, but I was just trying to explain the reason behind this. Calculate the percentage by mass of sulfur in sulfur trioxide SO3. From the periodic table, we can see that MR of sulfur is 32 and for oxygen it's 16. Mass of sulfur over mass of sulfur trioxide is 32 over 80 and multiply by 100 to find the percentage. It's 40%. Part C. Concentrated sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent which can chemically remove water from substances. Both hydrated copper to sulfate crystals and sucrose, a sugar, C12H2020O11, can be completely dehydrated by concentrated sulfuric acid. Name the solid product formed in each case. Hydrated copper to sulfate. After it's dehydrated, it will be called an anhydrous copper to sulfate. For sucrose, when it's dehydrated, all hydrogen and oxygen atoms will be gone, so it will be just carbon. Part D. When propan-1O is heated with concentrated sulfuric acid as a catalyst, an unsaturated hydrocarbon of relative molecular mass 42 is formed and one other product. What is meant by the term unsaturated? Unsaturated means not all bonds are single, so there can be double or triple bonds. Write the chemical equation for this reaction. Now again, you need to be aware of this kind of reaction where alcohol is heated with sulfuric acid, an unsaturated hydrocarbon, and some other product is produced. Propanol is C3H7OH, so first write it down, and this will produce an alkene and water. So that will be C3H6NH2O. We know that it's C3H6 because they said the MR is 42 and the MR of C3H6 is also 42. Name the unsaturated hydrocarbon formed. What's the name of C3H6? It has 3 carbon atoms, so it's propene. That's all for this video. I'll do the rest in my next video, so stay tuned. Tell me if this video helped you in the comments. It really motivates me. Thank you for watching and subscribe and like my videos, please. Stay safe and God bless you guys. Bye.